Saturday Geeks exploration video with me, Dr. Hopper,
and so we are currently sitting here, well, standing here, waiting for the fix. And then we will go from there and go down the nice little road.
We're getting some weird looks on this platform. We're actually using a camera in public. Apparently, that's not usual. Even more randomly.
The issues will work. So,
It's relatively wet, so
I'm being smacked in the face.
Yeah, we are literally being smacked in the face. Literally we've got to go down this long steep road. And hopefully do a bit of a trek going in. This will be the video actually. So you'll see the amount of walking we're really gonna do. So far, I mean, I can't see a bloody thing, but still, you know. Right, every 60 minutes, past the hour. Check your watch.
5:05.
That means we've just missed one. So, go for a hike. Hang on, are you sure it's that? Yeah, anyway, right, so unfortunately, folks, it does turn out that we actually have got a long walk to go down. So, we'll see you guys at the entrance to the Backcountry Museum if we survive.
Trust the British weather. They do us injustice on this night.
Shut up! That was the 24th!
No, hang on, John.
Bye!
John. Oh, come back here, you idiot. Right, folks, so as you can see from the sign behind us, John, let me stand up a little bit. Yeah. So we are literally, we're back into the museum now. We're going to go inside and start. But God's sake, are we now?
Hello, we don't get English.
Hey, they've got traditional fish and chips in here. Anyway.
Okay.
Onwards.
Bye-bye.
See what we see.
Don't light a match.
This is my job.
Chitty bang bang?
No, try again.
Chitty bang bang?
Bessie.
Oh, ah, yeah.
Not John Pertwee's vehicle
induction.
Yeah.
Well.
Oh, yes, it does. Because it was back then, wasn't it? Well, it was close to it. Don't know why I just said a foul or false. Oh, no, because he liked that sort of vehicle, didn't he? Oh, OK, it reminded me now. It's triggered.
I'm guessing it'll be test.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that one particularly. Definitely. Yeah, it's a general easier with one of the top notch bits of sort of course down.
Imagine the imagine driving on these. Heck, when I can't even drive now, but you know.
These days would cost.
Also, I think you'll find that like petrol is advanced as well.
Yes, it wouldn't be a lot less optimised than it would be these days. It would be dirty.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hang on, this can't be how they actually manufacture the vehicles, is it?
No, but it could be how they maintain them.
True, it's faster. That's a good point. But doesn't the technology move well, out of place, should I say. Well, and again, they could have used something like that, I don't know.
Oh yeah, the technology itself is out of place. This is where they keep the maintained, so that you can look at them and whatnot. I guess. Are they using these as vehicles that they can actually drive?
No, look, the thing machine over there. But no, I think what you'll find is they used to put vehicles like this in a place like this, so we could learn from the engine and advance them. That's my theory.
Okay.
As you were singing, John. Go on. Go on. Go on. Go on, dude.
Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler?
No, I'm not going to do it. So,
do not walk on the tram.
I wasn't, hoping.
These like the old fashioned gardens and whatnot. Ah, John.
Used in the war for other things, so you can't have the red. That's a luxury to have it on them. This product is made with plain chocolate. Our standard chocolate crisp will be reintroduced as soon as milk is available. So even the chocolate that was sold like this was on ration, what they could put in it. Absolutely everything. Mm. So that puts it into perspective, don't it?
Yeah, it really does.
It does. Interesting, isn't it?
Especially at Easter.
Yeah. So when you're having full-on pork chops on yogurt, you'll just think, of course, your veggies, you'll grow as much as you want. You grow it, you'll eat it, don't you?
Yeah.
Rabbit stew is the preferred meal around here. Rabbit stew. Thumper's going to get it on the ground.
Unless the front door.
Was that the front?
We just come for the back door. Remember, it was a garden.
Oh, yes, of course it was. That's what it would look like when you walked in. Look at the light switch.
So, we are sitting on us, right? That's what we're going to say. The world's first
built the actual first steam engine.
See, you know, I think you'll find that all this goes actually further down. Lovely and warm here, eh? But it's great in the winter.
Oh my, oh that's pretty. That is pretty. It's like, you've got the wrong colour on your phone. The colour correction's wrong.
Yeah, I know, I don't know.
Behind you,
absolutely
perfect cold. That's very clever. Pushed water out, threw up the pipe and out, down the shaft.
I think that was the first engine ever built, and that is in England as well.
Yeah, it makes you feel even
better. First steam engine, sorry, I should say.
Specific. Makes you feel even more better.
Yeah.
well, that was refurbished, by the way, Max.
Oh, so it's not exactly the old image.
Yeah, but it's good to see how the match, you know what it says?
It says no entry by that gate there. And, I thought that was like a staff-only access area. It's not. It's literally your way out. If you're underneath the ground and you want to go out straight away, you don't want to go through there, you can just go straight out.
Onwards.
Always on.
Have it trimmed and fumbled away, wouldn't it? Yeah. Yeah.
Radio Gripton stores. Oh my god.
What? Yeah, that was 2012.
Appears to be taking it away on holiday, and I want to eat it.
Well, all these, you call them, you call that practical.
For a mouse, yes. I don't know what I'm doing with this accent, but
the fish, oh my god, the fish look right.
Potatoes are a oil, I suppose, but I'm partial to a bit of fish and chips, mate.
You
can't
have all these.
Yeah, they use vegetable oil on request, apparently.
Request of who?
It's oil, it's olive oil, but they use vegetable oil on request. If you don't want to use olive. Just say that.
Dibby episode.
Pickle Dibby episode?
Yeah. Ah, chocolate fountain. She starts using the cups, the glasses, to drink the chocolate. But she just loves it that much. She says, I'm going in, and she sticks her head in it.
You don't want to bring that back? I want to bring Pickle Dibby back.
With actual, dull French.
It ain't working. I'm not alone.
Oh,
the bugger. It's gone inside. But we have to eat on a bench because Jack here, well, he loves the outdoors. A bit too much for my liking.
Well, that I didn't want to eat this. Talking to you, surrounded by them lot.
True, we couldn't probably have done this. We'd have done that. We're doing it for you guys. We're taking... the piece of paper's been... Bye! See ya! I'm off on holiday.
Was anyone watching?
I'm free!
No one was watching. Was that really thought?
I can't get up. My hands are so cold, I couldn't pick it up.
Ah, there's a bin over there.
If it's still... Jack, will you go pick that paper and put it in the bin along with it?
Yes, yes, darling, I will.
While you can catch it. Oh, what a lovely place. There's a bench that's tipped over. Either the wind did it, or some teenagers really got angry with this wind.
Yeah. I think I'll go for the batter.
Right. If the wind did it, we should leave.
Yeah. Well, if my phone starts flying, I'm diving.
Try and swallow first before you open your mouth. Jesus Christ, I'm moving over here.
Oh, that's hurt me from it.
Stop.
Well, that's wrong.
Very low. Interesting.
They can't really have real minds though, can they?
No.
Because it would be dangerous.
We definitely went under something.
Oh yeah, it was it was on the ground.
Well
yeah, it was done on purpose.
Of course, so. Done by proper coal and everything else. We definitely went under the ground.
It wouldn't be a real mine though, because they can't really, because if there is gas underneath there, it's quite waste.
Well, the only mine around here was one of the videos that went national day 1968, which means that the mine was not fired earlier. Anyway, so folks, what we plan to do now is go into the actual village itself and explore around there.
Yeah.
right, so we just took a bag from it and
so that was brilliant.
We got aniseed balls, one licorice and what was it, barley sugar you got?
I just thought it looked right, like big and sweet, so I just thought, you know what, back then. Right, so I'm going to join the village then.
Yep.
You know what I remember? Last time I came here, my mum and granddad, it was during Easter and they had like an Easter hunt. In like the window there, that was where the, one of the eggs were. I actually remember being here.
Do the metal work, it's effectively a metal work in white, it's a steel top work.
This is really astonishing. See, I think they're more like unpleasant, if you know. What?
Will this still be the
I've seen somebody working already. I mean, I thought we'd see someone working on one of these. Anyway, onwards and upwards. Nice and fun, so this is the last thing I'm actually going to do before the end actually. Well then, that was very interesting. We just walked back through Blackwood Trees and come back out. We've got the main entrance here.
How wide is very good? How bright do I have?
Very good. Some footage that I'm going to overlay in this video right now, so let's see what we actually saw. And perhaps towards the end, before we actually finish off, I'll put the rest there so you can see for yourselves.
It's tipping it down at the moment.
Yeah, but that was beautiful looking all around. Just seeing how they actually managed to.
The calcium and
The calcite, the stalagmites.
Yeah.
Stalagmite, I think, points up, and stalagmite, I think, points down all the way around. But the idea of bands working there.
Yes, and explain.
And, you know, like performances and whatnot. I never would have assumed that something like that would actually happen. So, I mean, just, of course, I think it is, but. So we found that very, very interesting, folks. And we're now going to finish the day off and head on home.
Yep.
So this is the last video, whatever clip I put this in, whatever part of the video. This is the last video in the series.
truly enjoy it. We truly enjoy making it. I know I enjoy editing it.
It's a good day, apart from the weather.
Which is future tense. Yeah, the weather has that damn book.
Turn around, it's just here about in and out of the cabin. The crowd, the mic is no longer. If you want to look at me for a sec, use this implement. I've got it in my hand right now. Now, believe it or not, but a lot of you on this boat have used this implement in the same. Anybody use the expression? I wouldn't touch him with a barge pole. Is that same? Yeah. You've not in? You've never had?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Oh, well. It may be when you get older. But if you never know what you were talking about when you said it, this is the barge pole that you wouldn't touch him with. It had a sharp point and a hook, and it was used for jabbing into the brickwork, all the lights out, depending on where they were, and barging my way down the tonic. See what I'm doing right now? Is barging my way around with this barge pole. Unfortunately, these barge poles had a nasty side effect, and that side effect is the damage it did to the tonic, where the brickwork was damaged. I'll show you when we get round to the other part round the corner again, and I'll show you how much damage I was doing to the walls. And they banned them from using the barge poles in these tunnels. So they think of another way of transporting the boats. Well, they came up with this poor leg in the boat down the tunnel. Now, I've got a plank in the centre of the boat there, so the question is, would anybody like to have a go at legging the boat down the tunnel? All you've got to do is, although the plank is a bit wet, so I'll tell you. anybody want to have a go at legging the boat? No? No? You don't want to have a go. Anybody on the show?
No, thank you.
No, thank you. Okay. I wouldn't recommend it anyway. On a damp day like today, that plank is quite wet now, aren't it? Nothing we can do about that, I'm afraid. Although we do actually is lie on that plank, put the feet on the walls and let you walk down the walls. I'm saying that, but that's when they started. But after a very short distance, they start to get quicker and quicker and quicker. And they would end up running down the tunnel, or most of the way down, actually. That's how good they can do it. It would take the limit some 3.5 to 4 hours to leg it down the full length of this tunnel. And once I got to the other end, of course, I didn't pop the boats. I went on to other boats and leg it all the way back again. And I did that 6 days a week, 12 to 14 hours a day. That's how they used to do it. Now, the lines that we're travelling through now, you know, Mr. No Brickwork, I'm doing anything, all people have to be quiet. It also wasn't mine either, although it is mine, so it's very poor quality. If you look to our left-hand side, which you're looking at now on the left there, you see the different shades of grey in this limestone. And of course, when this was being laid down, when we were under ETOs at the time, and about 428 million years ago, we were taken there too, it's interlaced with mud, volcanic ash, and that's the reason why it's still there. It's not good enough quality to make the best quality of limestone to make the best quality of limestone. So we eased up a little bit of a rain, so we'll be alright to go out again. You might notice the tunnels are different shapes. Remember I told you the 12 shafts, each shaft had their own gang of bricklayers, each shaft had their own gang of navigators who put the tunnels out. But the bricklayers had their own way of building the tunnels. Sometimes it's arch shape, sometimes it's high, sometimes it's low, and sometimes it's round, it might be these at this bit. And this is what they used to do, this is why there's all different shapes and sizes. Right, the tunnel we're just entering into now is our 1989 tunnel. I think it's very guessing when this was built. Yeah, 1946, now 1989. It was built for our second adventure purpose because the tunnel we're using is not for 14 this evening. So we close for safety reasons. We started digging this tunnel nice and the curve to the left. When I got to this one, where the purple light slot, I found a natural fault in the limestone, so they just followed this natural fault, and that's why we meander around a little bit from now on. If you look to the ceiling, you know, it doesn't need support whatsoever. Well, I couldn't stabilise the water moisture anyway, it's got a concrete torn over it. It's less than an inch thick, and it's just something that's been barred from dropping in such a go around. Even so, the calcite's come through and so the stalactites forming on the ceiling as well from place to place. Mm.
section of the stone left behind a network of vast caverns, which would be an attraction for scientists, engineers, and visiting dignitaries from abroad. The Dudley Caverns have also played an important role in the development of the science of geology, and became renowned internationally for the quality and diversity of the fossils that have been discovered here. In 1849, addressing a meeting of scientists here in the Dudley Mines, the eminent geologist Sir Roderick Murchison proclaimed that in no part of England are more geological features brought together in a small compass than in the environs of Dudley. In the 1850s, the caverns were opened to the public. Gas lighting was installed, paths laid out, and a vast land constructed. Many fairs and concerts were held in these mines, with entertainment provided by orchestras, choirs, and military bands. Cannon fairs were attended, and demonstrations of blasting were carried out. Those events were perhaps the forerunner of today's classical spectacular concerts. And although some of the mines were accessible from the surface, many visitors came by canal boat, just as you have today. Since those times, technology has moved on, and we no longer have to risk the dangers of gas and gunpowder to provide light and sound. But imagine for a moment the awe and amazement of those early visitors, as we present our modern interpretation of those events nearly 200 years ago.